Hello guys, how are you? So today I'm going to discuss about content encoding or text compression using a Node Express server. So here I have an application which is a React application, and it has been built or bootstrapped using Create React App. It's a simple application, so it has three routes. So this is the home page, then you have a details page, and then finally an edit page. Alright, so let's refresh this once again, and since we are talking about compression today, so we'll mostly focus on content encoding and text compression. So now, to talk about compression, the first thing that you can notice here is the size column. So here are two rows in the size column. In case you don't see two rows, you can go ahead and enable it from here in this option. So you can enable and it will show you two rows. So the first line here is actually the size that is getting downloaded, and the second one is the actual size of the file that is there on the server. So in this case, you see the sizes of both the rows are the same, which means that we are actually downloading bigger payloads over the network. So this is 152 kilobytes, but imagine a bigger chunk, which is around 380 or 300 kilobytes. So in that case, we'll be downloading the entire 300 kilobytes over the network. So this will make our website overall loading slow. We'll also download more kilobytes or more bytes of data. So overall your website will feel slow, it will download slow, your time to interactive will be high. As a result, your performance will be hampered. So we can actually go ahead and find that. So in the audits panel, we can do a Lighthouse audit quickly. And let's wait for the report. So it's checking the various parameters of the Lighthouse test, and there's the report. So as you can see here, the first opportunity that it has shown me is enable text compression. So that is exactly what it's saying, that all my files, whatever my static files, JavaScript files and my CSS files, and even if I have any JSON data or something, so that needs compression. So there are usually two popular compression techniques or algorithms used in the server. So they are gZip and Rocky. So both are widely supported. So today we will be discussing about gZip. And so right now there is no compression. Hence you see this opportunity shown to us by Lighthouse. Also you can, if you see in the network panel, so you can see the entire bundle is getting downloaded. Okay, so this is actually loading from the cache. Let me hard refresh again. And you can see it's actually downloading the actual size, so even here. Alright, so let me go back to the audits panel and just quickly take you to the Google document, what it says. So if you go and learn more, you can open the Google documentation, web dev documentation. So here they have told that text-based resources should be served with compression to minimize total network bytes. The opportunity section of your Lighthouse actually reports this. Alright. So what files is actually reports about? So mostly it will be JavaScript, CSS files, and files that has text in them or content. It will not report the same issue for images. For images, there is a different way of compressing images. Either you can use a library called ImageMin, or you can use Image CDN. I think Akamai has an Image CDN where they actually host your images. And when your server actually, or when the browser requests the image, it will serve with compression and different resolutions and sizes. We're not going into that, but let's continue with the text compression. So as I said, there are two popular compression algorithms. One is Brotli and the other is gZip. So we are talking about gZip today, and my server is actually a Node Express server. Alright, I think nothing much here. We'll get back to the server and the code, and I'll explain you how to enable compression. Alright, so this is my application, and here is my server.js file. So this is a Node Express server, so I'm just importing Express and initializing it, and then finally I'm starting the server at port 5000. Also, if you notice here, this is the static path which has been defined in the middleware, and it is exposing the build folder, which is here. So the entire build folder is defined as a static path. So whatever is inside will be directly, the browser can download. And what is build? So since this is a React application, so the build folder is actually the Webpack production build, which has been generated using the Webpack command. So if I go to my package JSON, so you can see the build command, so I can go ahead and generate a build at runtime or at build time, sorry. So it will generate the build at the build folder, and once I start my server, it will serve the build folder at port 5000. And if you go inside the build folder, this is the index page. This is where the JS and CSS files live. So all my chunks are here, and even the CSS chunks are here. Okay, so let's add compression. So the first thing to do is to import the module called compression. So it comes built in with Node. And what's my Node version? So let's quickly check. Okay, so I'm using a Node version of around 10. And compression is available to me, so I can directly go ahead and say variable compression, and I can say compression. So it has the compression library available to it, and I can directly go ahead and now enable compression. So for that, I'll be using the middleware structure app.use, and then I can say compression. So this will add gZip compression to my application, and I can go ahead and start my server, and it will start at 5000. Let me go back to my app and refresh it. Okay, let's close this, go to the network panel, let's refresh it again. So I'll do a hard refresh, and now let's look at the size column. So where's my main chunk? Okay, so the main chunk, I don't know why its size is less. Anyways, the 27 kilobytes, what was the original size, now only 8.7 kilobytes are being downloaded. Even if you see the total size here, it has reduced. So there is compression that's happening. And alright, so this is the 152 kilobyte file that I was looking for. So now only 47 kilobytes of data has been downloaded. So if I go and see the response headers, so you can see content encoding gZip. So that means gZip is happening. So my browser, when it sends a request for the file, it sends as what kind of encoding it can accept. So this is the request header, accept encoding. So it tells it can accept gZip, deflate, and broadly. And the server responds back, since it has enabled gZip, so server responds back with saying content encoding gZip. That means the file has been encoded using gZip algorithm. Since these are text content, what is text content? So basically it's the JavaScript, so these are all text based content. So gZip will go ahead and compress all the text based content files. Alright, so now since we have enabled compression, let's go into the audits panel and run an audit again and see if the error is reported again. Alright, so if you notice, the score has improved, and that opportunity that was there before, it's not there right now. So since we have enabled compression, now it's going and it has passed our test. So if you see here, enable text compression. So it's actually in green color, which means we have passed the test. All right, so that was an easy example of how you can use a Node Express server and enable compression to compress your content and serve less payload to the browser, so that your application is loaded faster and time to interactive is higher. So for that, Node already comes with a compression module, so you can just import it and then use it in the middleware. So that will enable gZip compression. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope it makes some sense to you. So go ahead and give this a try. I'll see you soon.